two centuries, the Shana Corporation has used borrowed futuristic technologies to provide Traveller, Python, CG, Skyrim, and bikini videos for the subscribers of this YouTube station.
I got a Dwemer. Oh, there's a horse in town? I got a Dwemer ruin scene coming up in this video, but it might be so loud. I don't know if my voice will even be heard in the commentary. So we shall find out. So before I go to Solstheim, I know I've been saying for like the last five episodes, I'm on my way to Solstheim.
Excellent. You've done us a great service. Here is your reward.
Well, in this video, I actually make it to Solstheim.
The Jarl has put out a bounty on some bandits. Here, take a look at this decree for details.
In about 2.5 minutes, I'll be there.
Always a pleasure.
So I'm just getting the bounties. I'm collecting bounties because I just don't want to be dealing. Because if I end up... I don't know. I don't want to, like... do the bounties after I do the Dwemer thing. Because then if I decide I don't want the Dwemer thing, I go back and my game saves. And then I have to redo the bounty things again. It's hard to explain, but... Oh, I need goggles. Where's my goggles? I didn't bring goggles. Where's Lucien? Lucien's got goggles. Give me those. Give me those.
Take whatever you need.
Taking those. I'm taking them.
Right behind you.
He'll just spawn new ones if he needs any. Oh, okay. Now I can see. So what's the plan? We spend the night. Oh, I can't sleep in this place. Whatchamacallit? I must have chopped out stuff because we're here way too early in the video. Anyway, I can't sleep because then I'll end up at the temple. Stuck building a temple, etc., etc. So I have to remember to not sleep ever while I'm in Solstheim.
Is there some way I can assist you?
I have a message for you.
Tell my father if he wants to speak to me, he should do it in person.
It's not from your father.
Is something amiss, Captain Derby? I can sense your concern.
I'm covered in ash.
Nothing.
I'm going to be fine, my love. Captain Velith would never allow anything to happen to us.
Perhaps that's reassuring enough for you, but it's something that still keeps me awake at night. There are so many delightful ways I've pictured you dead.
Oh, man.
Vendel Severin. A pleasure to meet you, Serio.
Pleasant journey.
Vegetables ready for you soon.
She's upset with me because I'm so beautiful.
Tell you what, if you use them to make your Quama egg stew, you can have them for free. It's a deal.
That's weird. You can only have one thing applied to your body, either ash or blood and dirt. So I'm waiting for the blood and dirt script to kick in. So I want to say, see, I don't have any dirt or blood on me. Okay, now there's no ash on me. Okay. I'm perfectly clean, it looks like. Sort of, maybe. Oh, there's ash on me again. Oh, man. Okay, that's dirt. That's not ash, that's dirt. Now, okay, now I got dirt and blood on me. Dirt and... what is it? It's caked on dirt and caked on dried blood. That's what it is. Okay. I don't know why, but this reminds me, I need to fix Ildari, hot Ildari, so that she looks like the one that Pandorable did, and not the one that Nerd of Prey did. Is he the one who, yeah, Nerd of Prey, I think, did hot Ildari. I mean, I've installed the patch to use Hot Ildari with Pandorable's NPCs from Dragonborn, but it's not working. So I'm wondering if Pandorable NPCs got an update since the Hot Ildari patch. So I'll have to make my own patch, it looks like. So I thought I'd show a scene from the Dwemer Ruin that me and Lucien are exploring. It's pretty quiet in this part of the dungeon. It's not so...
looks like the same arrangement here. If you could just hit the button, the first door should close, and with a bit of luck, the second should open.
Yeah, other parts. Once we're in the...
marvelous. Don't panic, I'm certain
it'll... once we're in the bowels of this ruin, it gets pretty loud. I can't move. I guess we're waiting for it.
On we go.
Okay. For some reason, the author doesn't want me to move until the door starts opening, which is kind of weird. I guess we're supposed to make our marks first. Before we come into this area here. One of these doors is the up, and one of these doors is the down. I guess this is the down. Okay. Nope, that's the up. So we go this way. This way has the button. Up, up, up. This way's got the button, I guess.
Visitors.
Did you hear that? I don't suppose it could have been the wind. Wind that talks.
Okay, so we're going this way. Okay, now it starts getting noisy. This person kept hiding. Every time there's a fight scene, she's nowhere to be found. I think it's because she's using ranged weapons, and she likes to use them from far away. Lucien kept getting knocked down. I probably should have given him some armor to wear. this dungeon's pretty huge. You can still exit the dungeon. I don't remember if I tried or not, but I didn't find any doors that were locked behind us. Unless they're talking about that one main door we came in that required both of us to push buttons at the same time. That door could have been shut for all I know. Okay, I gotta fix him again. Come on, third person work. Wrong button. There we go.
Let's get going. Lead on.
Thank you. This one looks broken. A lot of this dungeon is symmetrical, so you can come in from other doors and you end up in the same area basically. You're either on the left side or on the right side.